We're just going right in. But yeah, today's just cleanup day. And who knows, depending on how long it will be, it might be even tomorrow as well. Or tomorrow? No, not tomorrow. Tomorrow's gonna be, it's gonna be Friday, so Saturday. But I mean, I'm hoping I can get everything done today. All the cleanup I need to do today. But we'll see. It's really just gonna depend on the monster drops. I noticed there was actually some monster encounters over here. I think it was over here. No, it wasn't over here. What was it at? It was here. There was like some monster encounters here I could do that I haven't gotten on the bestiary. And I'm just curious. Because we are missing a few bestiary entries as well. Oh, it's another back attack. Oh, these are new. I think, anyway. Well, check it out. Yep, that was one. It actually says overworld. That's interesting. It says specifically overworld only. Whoops. Yeah, it says we're missing a few here. We got two, it looks like? Okay. I don't know if this one does the thing that Final Fantasy 1 Pixel Remaster did. Like, after you beat the game, it just teleports you out onto the world map and you can continue playing. I got a little nap in before I hopped on here. Okay, yeah, these are new. So, I'm feeling pretty good to go. Even though I'm a little bit late, that was my fault. I wanted to eat before I hopped on. I did wake up before 10 o'clock. But yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. I might actually still go, I might actually go for 3 hours too today. It just depends on the tedium, I suppose. Let's check that out real quick. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Wait, can those drop the, Yes, they can. There was a monster we missed in the Summoner's Cave. No, not still cave. Yeah, we're missing a monster in the Cave of Summons. So, let's go do that before we start grinding the monster summon drops. Miss any chests here. Go back on the world map and check real quick. Oh, okay, yeah, we missed quite a bit of stuff here. Okay. So we'll go ahead and try to get all the chests we can as well. I'm thinking the Santana. Okay, yeah. That was three. No, I was mistaken. Never mind. Run across a summoner, let it summon, just in case. Close enough. Nice radio. I'm pretty sure we fought this guy before. Okay, There is a chest over there we need to try to grab. So it's time to go run into walls. We're floating, so your earthquakes will not do us any harm on this day of today. That is Thursday. Thursday. Now, I know I had Kane attack that one back in the back. It's really weird. Okay, so it must have been a monster in a box. Well, no, I think we fought these guys. Ooh, Rydia. Probably not going to be too useful now. It's pretty good for Kane. I meant to heal. I just like how Kane just could equip axes and swords and whatnot. It's very unfitting for a dragoon. It's pretty funny. Just makes Kane unique, you know? It said two items, so maybe I missed something from a jar. It's empty. I don't think... think there was anything hidden. I don't know if the maps actually show hidden areas or not. Ah, must have found it. Maybe he was the warrior. Whoops. No, it was the spider! Really? Right? Yeah, that was the- yeah, it was the spider. Huh. Okay. Fought her before. Kind of weird to go through that cave and not fight her. I thought I remember her being like a very common encounter. Oh! That was an item. I was about to say, what? A book that summons a monster you won't know which until you try it. Huh. Okay, so the book cases, the book cases can have idols on them. Yep, there we go. Okay. Well, that's dead, unless there is chests here. Yeah, unless the fat chocobo has some other purpose, then it's weird because you just don't have an inventory shortage. I guess we could use eggs anyway. Chess. We're missing an item down there too. Okay, is specific, is it pointing out the fat, the town or the... No, it's pointing out both of them. Okay. No, okay, so the Cave of Summons is good. The Land of the Summons is not. Right? Yeah. So we're missing four chests in the Land of Summons itself. Got it. Okay. But we did get the two items. Oh, excuse me, they're not Santana, they're mini Santana. That's a weird bug. That's a very weird bug. Okay, so we're missing four chests here. Let me look up something here. I remember looking at it and remembering that... I think this was one of the places that had a hidden chest. Like a hidden chest in the original vanilla game. I don't know if they added to this one or not. Oh, maybe I'm mistaken. No, it was the steel cage that had it, okay. So that wouldn't count towards it then. I don't want to look up where these chests are just yet. I want to try to see if I can find them. But it is specifically saying four chests here. That was the wrong way, wasn't it? No, it wasn't. Okay. I feel like there was a teleporter somewhere. I think that's what it was. Maybe. Yeah, because you can see something down there. Unless that's just for flavor. Definitely missing something here. I feel like there's a teleporter somewhere I'm just not finding. And I'm gonna be feeling very dumb when I do find it. Yeah, that's just that. There's nothing here. I'm gonna look it up. Hmm. Well, the first picture that comes up on the Final Fantasy Wiki for it is actually an image of the four chests sitting in a square, so... So I'm reading something here. I was reading something, it's like, step on the... What was it? Step on the diamond-shaped plate in the southern part of the area. I'm like, what are you talking about? Okay, that, I mean, that, now looking at that, those look odd. Well, that takes care of that, but there's something interesting here that I want to check out. Takes care of those. Oh, we gotta be in a dungeon. Got it. Yeah, now it just sticks out now that I'm looking at it. Itself. Okay. Lally-ho. Hmm. said it was 2, if I'm not mistaken. It's just depressing. I feel like it's very easy to go Husk here. There's one. I think we looked at all the ones we can. Except maybe that one there, but it looks like I can't. Probably the same situation here. There we go. Okay. So we're done here. Oh, I have to go in one of them. Got it. I wasn't expecting to go ahead and start doing some treasure grinding. It's pretty funny. Oh, I'm gonna go all the way down there. Let me go over here first. Shoot, look at this. Okay, that's cool. Actually, did not know about that. Yep. And I did promise that if I got another one, I was gonna use it on Kane, just so he has MP. Look at that, Kane's got 10 MP now. He can never use it, but he has it. We actually have to go all the way down here now. Which we did get all the chests here, right? Actually, no, we're missing some chests there, aren't we? Oh my god, we're missing 18 chests? Jeez. I might actually put that off for right now. Well,
15, though? Holy cow.
I don't think there's anything on this floor. I think I'm gonna actually meet some enemies here too. Or maybe not. I don't think so, actually. These guys, I'm just gonna run away from. Well, I might be able to one-shot them now. I'll give it a shot. Okay, yeah, I know I remember seeing those. That's 9 right there, holy cow. So that's a path to somewhere. That's the noise Muhammad makes, by the way. Did I really never come down this way? That's insane. Excalibur being a chunky sword for whatever reason. But, he swings it. I can't believe I never came this way. Get the tiny toad! Sir. Actually, that looked kind of suspicious. It probably means nothing, but I can check it out. I just don't get it. Ah. can't believe I missed all this. I was a dummy. No, not quite enough. Not counter-attack, though. Which is interesting. Mega Flare. Bomb is pretty good. And I feel like it's definitely a lot quicker to summon him now. For sure. Okay, so you're forced. Okay. Well, you're not forced to. It's probably just a shortcut. I do remember this room, though, now. Not that I'm here, I do remember this. He's probably gonna cast Mad Breath. Yep. Mini with Shades. That's pretty powerful. It's the same thing, right? Yeah. Just to mix it up. I don't like this one at all. You can't run away from this either, can you? I don't think Leviathan is going to be strong enough against these guys to one-shot them. Okay, we're good. The buff frog. Yeah, like, I'm too overpowered at this point for some of this stuff. Which, that's more on me. Reliable place to buy ethers was there. I don't recall off the top of my head. Yeah, honestly, the only thing really concentrating on Radia at this point is her MP and just her agility, really. But with Bahamut, she's pretty much good to go. Not done there yet, we gotta go back down. Yep, so that's all 30 of them. Really not as bad as I remember it being when I first played this on the PlayStation, this particular dungeon. Of course, I kind of rushed things, I believe. Like, I was trying to, like, I wasn't grinding as much as I did during this playthrough and past playthroughs. Thank you. They looked at me funny. So, I'm thinking, after I'm done wrapping up with Final Fantasy IV, which will probably be, depending on how cleanup's gonna go, quite a bit, few more sessions, then I'm gonna go back to Hades. Because for Disgaea 6, I've beaten the game in Disgaea 6, but I haven't done everything I wanted to do in Disgaea 6. But I want to go ahead and go try to see if I can get Hades knocked out. Then, what I'm thinking is I might actually go ahead and start Super Robot Wars OG2. Instead, I mean, I don't know if that will be December at that point or not. There it is. There's the item that I missed out on. But, yeah, I might actually start that sooner. Cool. Okay. But that was a little detour. Now let's go grind on some goblins. Do I want to do goblins? You know what? Let's get the hard one out of the way first. Or I feel like we'll beat the hard one. Because you can only encounter these guys in this one cave. Missed some items over here, which I thought I did know, because I remember looking around here. I'm like, I'm pretty sure there's some items here. But it is pretty cute that it's just shaped like a chocobo. Mistaken, like there's items here. It says there's three. It's a little bugged. Aren't you supposed to be, like, in the grass? Or maybe I'm misremembering. The chocobos don't give you, items, do they? No, I didn't think so. I don't think the fat... Maybe... Hold on. Something. One. edited. Oh, well, okay. Here we go. Wait, am I really... Oh, that's funny. Yeah, it's pretty funny. Alright, yeah, let's get this one out of the way. Question is, do I want to waste a siren on this thing? Or do I want to do it the hard way? I should have looked if I got everything here. I'm pretty sure I did get all the chests here. Okay, here's one. Cool. Okay. I think they are considered the rarest enemy in this map here. How many do I have? Might not be too bad then. But yeah, this is the, in this particular version, this is the only way we're gonna be able to encounter this guy, is right here in this dungeon. Otherwise, you can encounter him in a bonus dungeon, because, if I'm not mistaken, I actually never did a bonus dungeon in the GBA version, or the PSP version, I don't think about it. That you can counter any enemy in the game in that bonus dungeon. Got a little bit of Dr. Pepper with me today. Not sponsored. Unless they want to sponsor me. That'd be pretty funny. It's like this. This Twitch streamer that only has, like, a couple of viewers every once in a while. He likes our Dr. Pepper. Let's sponsor him. Say, the CEO man, I don't think that's very viable. Nonsense. I didn't say how much to give him, though. I like how Kane just has 10 MP. Just no reason. Okay, these might not be too hard to encounter as I thought they were gonna be. Or run into, I should say. Now, dropping the item on one, that's a different story. And you have no penalty from running away, so... So that's pretty good. Kill these guys. It's generally get a good idea how much EXP I can get from them. And Gil. Eh. Get a nice little chunk of change of Gil on there. Okay, now they're starting to be a little bit harder to find. Because the thing is, I could save Scum with the Sirens. And luckily, this is the PSP, or PSP, the PC version, so it's going to be loading up fairly quickly, but still, you gotta exit out of it, load it back up, and whatnot. And I do need to at least save one for the Plant Princess. Or if I'm Masochist, you know, I can get, try to get five of them. So I can get the five armors for each character. Which I never done that. I did do one. Because I remember specifically getting it in the PlayStation version. And I put it on Cecil, because of course. I will say this though, if the game does let me save and kicks me out into the overworld after the ending, I will add this to the random list that can be picked of games, and if it gets picked, I'll do a session of it, just trying to, like, max out or something, but outside of that, I'll be pretty much good to go. And the fact that I'm saying that I want to put this much time into Final Fantasy IV, you can probably take a guess that I'm gonna put it high on my RPG list. Like, I'm actually taking the time to trying to get these, monster drops. Like, I legitimately enjoy Final Fantasy IV. Final Fantasy IV is a very good game. And I'm glad that, while I wasn't able to experience it when it first came out on Super Nintendo, that I was able to experience it while I was still younger on the PlayStation. Like, I was in my teens at this point, but, I don't know if I played this before I played 9. I played 7 before this, I know that for sure. I played 8 before I played this. I just don't remember if I played this before 9. I remember getting the PlayStation version of this, too. It was dirt cheap, like $20. And they're actually still not too expensive, because you can actually still buy these, the PlayStation version, for pretty cheap off of Square's store. Like, they just had a surplus. This and Final Fantasy IX are fairly cheap, if I'm not mistaken. They're the greatest hits versions, but, you know, that's not a big deal. At least to me, it's not a big deal. I'm actually going to look it up in price charting right now. Yeah, like, completing box Final Fantasy IX is $15. Like, that's not a bad deal at all if you want to play the original PlayStation version. Like, the Nintendo Switch version of Final Fantasy IX is more expensive than Vanilla IX. Which I need to keep an eye out for that. I'm pretty much thinking I'm gonna, like, make my Switch, like, mostly RPGs. Like, don't get me wrong, I am gonna, like, at some point I like to pick up Odyssey. And I guess, well, Fire Emblem is an RPG. I was about to say in Fire Emblem, but that is an RPG. So what about Final Fantasy? Was it Chronicles? That, 4 was on? It was Chronicles. That's the one with Chrono Trigger, that's right. Yeah, that's only $25. That's not a bad deal. Like, let me go to Square Enix to store right now. So good. Yeah, greatest hits version if you want on Final Fantasy IX on Square Enix store itself is $15. Wait, can you actually buy 7 from them? Or is this the PC version? No, I don't. Hold on. Okay, yeah, it's the Steam version. I'm looking at a Square Enix store and I'm like, wait, you can still buy the Steam version of Final Fantasy V on their store? Oh, that's funny. I don't think that's the Pixel Remaster. No, that's not the Pixel Remaster. Okay, so you can still get the Steam version of Final Fantasy V, the weirder looking graphic one, under store, it looks like. That's pretty funny. Games. I actually don't see PS1 Chronicles. Anthology. Looks like it's the more expensive one out of this PS1 game. It says $30. Okay. Okay. So I was wrong. I thought you could buy Chronicles and Anthology off of Square Enix store, but no. But you can buy 9. Which explains why Final Fantasy IX's price is so low. I want to get another copy of the original PlayStation version of Final Fantasy VII. That would be so rad to get another copy of that again. It's gone down in price quite a bit over the years, which is good. Like, for a complete version of Final Fantasy VII, I would happily pay $27. In fact, let me go on eBay right now. If I ever stream Final Fantasy VII, I would like to play the PlayStation Classic, or the PlayStation Original, on an actual PlayStation. I think that would be pretty rad. I have the means to do it. I just gotta pull up the old PlayStation to see if it works. Whoops. Yeah, I'm looking at what, yeah, $25, $25. Yeah, that's perfect. This one doesn't look like it comes with the manual. Hey, the manual for Final Fantasy VII is probably more expensive. Oh, that's the old Final Fantasy VII strategy guide. Oh, man. I have that, but it is beat up. I won't even lie. That strategy guide is beat up. There's another strategy guide for Final Fantasy VII that I've been hunting for years now. It's not a dedicated Final Fantasy VII guide, but I remember looking at that thing for years and loving, like, some of the stuff in it. It's from a game magazine. Was it this? No, it wasn't this. Even though this is pretty cool, the unauthorized ultimate guide that actually came with a poster. I would have loved to have that as a kid. I'm trying to remember what the name of that strategy guide was, or that video game book was. Oh, this is a Japanese guide. Holy cow, this looks awesome. That's with the poster, too. Poster looks pretty rad. Add that to the watch list. I don't think I have any traces of that guy anymore. The one I'm thinking of. Was it Game Informer? I don't know. Oh, was it PSM? Remember the cover having Final Fantasy VII characters on it. Yo, what? I won't pay $40 for that, but I'll get that. It was a PSM, apparently a PSM memory card? For Final Fantasy game? That was weird.
There's no way that was a...
choke. Ah. There's no way that was issue number one. There was Final Fantasy V Sears t-shirts. Yo, what? I don't remember that. Let's see if I can look this up. Was this an actual t-shirt? Looks cool, but I don't know if that's an official t-shirt. I don't know. I'm gonna have to really sit down and try to hunt for this thing. But I remember for years I've been trying to figure out what magazine it was. I don't remember anything else about it other than just a little Final Fantasy VII section. It had, like, a weapon guide at the end of it with pictures and everything. And, man, my young self thought that was the coolest thing ever. Start running away from these enemies. I don't think it was that ultimate unofficial guide. I just don't think it was that one. Oh, that PSM, PlayStation Magazine, was the very first one. That's interesting. Page guide. I mean, that sounds right, maybe? I wonder if, Internet Archive. I'm going on a tangent, I'm sorry. Or, completely... They don't have issue one. Oh, maybe they do. Hold on. I remember that. Well, hold on. We got a different... Okay, I'm confused here. 25 games you must play in 1999. Holy cow. That's funny. Hey, how you doing? Sorry, I had the tab off. Yeah, sprites don't look half bad at all. I was trying to look up a very specific video game magazine back in the day. No luck though. Final Fantasy IV is one of your favorites? Oh yeah, Final Fantasy IV is a personal favorite of mine. It's not my favorite Final Fantasy game. You really went on a tangent? I'm sorry. I apologize. But no, it's, you ever had that one thing in your head that you'd spent, like, it happens when you're younger, and you spend years trying to figure out what it is? Final Fantasy IV gives me huge Dragon Quest vibes. I can see it. Final Fantasy IV is definitely structured. It really is straightforward. Yeah, that's what I was about to say. Final Fantasy IV is very straightforward. Sadly, I didn't play the original Super Nintendo version when it came out, but I played the PlayStation version back in the days. And, it was pretty good. It's definitely top 5 Final Fantasy games for sure with me. Yeah, I heard the translation for the original Super Nintendo 4 was, really not good. Yeah, it was made for babies too, that's, yeah. They took a lot of stuff out of that game. Which is really weird. Yeah, he doesn't have darkness. They took out some of the, items. Oh, she didn't have aim either? That's messed up. Like, they said they... I think they said they wanted to make it less complicated, but I don't know. Oh, they changed the names with the Yang stuff. Man! They just... Ugh, that version just... I don't know. Maybe I am glad I just played the PlayStation version. Which is weird, because... Actually, I don't know if... No, Mystic Quest came after 4 on the Super Nintendo. Because I was about to say, if Mystic Quest came out before 4... But that wouldn't make sense, but no, Mystic Quest came after 4. Because 4 was 1991, which, by the way, this game is 30 years old now. It does. I love Mystic Quest. Mystic Quest was literally my first RPG. Oh, the OST, it rocks. Like, even people who don't like Mystic Quest, they will say, no, but the OST is awesome. Like, I've never met one person who dissed the Mystic Quest soundtrack. Oh yeah, take your time. Ah, I see. Oh yeah, you do what you gotta do. Don't get fired over my stream now. Sure, I did not get that drop. Oh, well, I'll run into the totem. I don't think I did yet. No, I didn't. Okay. Welcome back. They come rarely? Huh, really? Well, I guess it's... Well, what is today? Thursday? Yeah, Thursday. So I have a lot of time on my hands. Nice. Luckily for me, I'm able to listen to music or videos to catch up on at work myself because I work overnight, so I don't have to deal with customers. So they're like, oh yeah, yeah, you can listen to music or whatnot. Just don't put them on when you have customers around and, you know, we're closed overnight, so. It is a gas station, but the highway next to it is getting reworked. Oh, okay, there's road work, gotcha. There are only two lines. That are free? Ah, gotcha. Road work is funny. Where I live, this state in the United States in particular, we've had road work going on for 10 years, and they're still not done with it. And one is the other direction. That's funny. And you can only get to the station from the one line. Oh, okay. So you can't even cut across to get to it. It's literally on that side of the road. Gotcha. Oh, I need to run away from you guys. Not complaining. I still get paid. Nice. Watching videos while getting paid. I say that's pretty good. Yuri Camp Season 2? Oh, okay, neat. I think we talked about it a little bit last time. Really chill with comfort anime? Hey, I'm all about the comfort animes. Is all of Season 2 out? Or is it still going? Watch it then? I need to. I just got a backlog of stuff I need to get through. I think I'm gonna have to use a siren. Let me try it out, actually. I recommend watching it in the evening as a side thing. That sounds like a really good idea. Okay, so that is the rare encounter. It doesn't need a lot of focus. Okay. This is a little bit simpler doing it this way. Izzy, I never actually played After Years. I need to. I have the PSP version of After Years. I know about it. I don't know everything about it, but I know some stuff about it. So what do you want to know? I mean, I don't mind anything, really. Like, I'm the kind of person that you won't really spoil a game for me. Like, if anything, that gets me to want to play a game even more. I said, what do you want to know? Oh, gotcha. Well, let's see. What do I know? I know... There's two Kanes. I know you play as Cecil's son. I know it's multiple episodes. At least that's how the original version was, or multiple episodes. I know Rydia is kind of important. Okay, so I won't tell. Fair enough. Alright, it's in the docket. I need to play it. Especially now that I found a way I can stream from a PSP. So, that's pretty exciting. I just need to pick up a PSP as well. Because, unfortunately, mine died years ago. And it is an older model, too. Well, it is mostly fun. It's just Final Fantasy 4.2. I definitely have to check it out. So don't expect anything breathtaking. Oh, yeah. Like, if it was, then everybody I know would be talking about it. Like, I have a buddy who's played it, and he wasn't too fond of it. I remember that. But I think he played the Wii version. Which, rest in peace, Wii Shop. Are there new looks of the characters? Okie dokie. That's a high potion, I don't want that. I wish you could buy sirens. That'd be pretty nice if you could. Oh, wait a minute. Let me test something out here. What's the rare encounter here? It's the same thing. Okay. It does take a little bit to load up. Let's go further in. Welcome back to the chaos. Okay, same thing. Oh, does it? Oh, yeah, that's right, that's right, yeah. Different characters have combo attacks. It has so many, that's pretty funny. I've heard Edward is actually really good in that game, too. I haven't seen, like, either of them. Bro. Uh-oh. Edward is nuts? Oh, man. That's pretty funny. Since he's not limited to potions. Ooh. Any eye? Oh, that's good. That's real good. Even elixirs? Ooh, really? That's pretty good. This is where the boss is at, right? Yeah, there's no... Yeah, you can't do anything here. Cecil's gun is pretty good, too. Okay, that's cool to hear. I imagine he's probably a mix of Cecil and Rose. Okie dokie. Let me run it out here a little bit. It probably would be faster just to do this until I encounter him, rather than keeping the reset and the loading. Oh no, not a back attack. Okay, yeah, I guess I'm gonna have to use Siren. Yeah, he's good because he inherited good things from his parents. Okay, cool, cool. I figured he'd probably be a mix between the two. He has more MP spells. Ooh, okay. And he's kind of like a medium paladin. Can he cover like Cecil can? Nope, okay. Always Cecil can and one other character? Okay. I know there's a lot more ninjas he can recruit. Which is pretty funny. Edge is really good too. Okay, that's cool. I don't think Edge is terrible in this game, but Yang is definitely a much better character than Edge in this game for sure. He can throw spoons really well, that is true. Actually, it's not a spoon in this version, it's a knife. They fixed it, in quotes. Yeah, in the original translation, I think it wasn't a spoon in the original translation, and this one goes off more of the original translation. Other than Spoony Bar, they did keep the Spoony Bar line in this game. I love throwing spoons. Me too. Throwing spoons is a really good hobby. Oh yeah, they had to. Even in the Japanese version, they actually kept the Spoony Bar line from the English version for later Japanese releases because they loved that line so much. I'm gonna get this drop at some point. What is a Spoony Bar? That's a very good question. Actually, Ted Woosley didn't do that one. It was another guy who did Final Fantasy IV's translation. Yeah, Ted Woosley's first Final Fantasy game was 6. And I think he did Mario RPG as well, if I'm not mistaken. But I remember specifically looking it up, and I was taken aback. I was like, oh wow, he didn't do 4. That was somebody else. I know there's a specific translator. Actually, that's a good question. Did he do Chrono Trigger? I can look it up real quick. If I can spell his last name correctly. There it is. Two O's. Yeah, he did Chrono Trigger. He did Mystic Quest, Legends 3, 6, and he was working on the 5 translation before it was canceled. Yeah, because I remember originally they did plan on bringing 5 over here at one point back in the day, but it never happened. Indeed. Oh yeah, take your time. I understand. I don't want a high potion. And I have to save 1 for the Flame Princess. Because I don't know if I could get any more. I probably can get some more in the final dungeon. It's probably just a greater drop, too. I got more. I would really like to get one of these before the end of the session, which I am going to go for another hour, though. I think what I'm planning to do next time I stream Final Fantasy IV, I'm gonna go ahead and start the final dungeon. Grind on the Flame Princess, see if I can get a couple more sirens. Cause I have to leave the final dungeon once I get the drop anyway to get the armor. These things are harder to grind than the Princess Tail. Again, what am I doing? Let me look something up here. I wonder if you can buy it in this version. It doesn't mention that. I don't remember seeing it in the shops. I guess I could go check. I mean, I have to grind on balloons or grenades anyway on the moon. Yeah, let me go check. I don't remember being able to buy them, though. It'd be nice if you could. That MP. the new translation of Chrono Trigger on Nintendo DS, and it was so boring. Yeah, I heard a lot of people don't like Frog's translation in the Nintendo DS version. It was too literal. I mean, Ted Woosley did such a good job, man. They should have just used that. It lacked a charm. That's what a lot of people said. I still need to beat Chrono Trigger at some point. Or that's the other one. It felt like a fan translation, very safe. Oh. Yeah, a lot of fan translations tend to be, like, very by the books. Oh, that's the wrong switch. To the moon! I mean, if I played that version first, I would still love it. Oh yeah, like, gameplay-wise and all the additions, I'm sure, are great. But it's like you said, the, like, having played the Super Nintendo version first. Right. What was this cave at? I think it was this one, wasn't it? I never played the Super Nintendo version, but I did play the PlayStation version. Oh, it's down there. Okay. Hey, it had nice cutscenes. The worst one. I don't know. Is the PC version better? I heard the PC version when it first came out was bad. The load times, true. I know one of you guys sells stuff. Wait. Oh, that's just it. Okay, so you can't buy them in this version. Dang it. Enough said. What if you ran the PS1 version on a PS2 with faster load speed? Would that help? Oh, okay. Take your time. It was just a wind. It wouldn't? Okay, fair enough. It still uses the read speed of PS1? Okay, got it. For whatever reason, it still misses games. Oh, so the remix music in this game is fantastic. PC version is fine now, but they changed some puzzles, which is kind of boring. I also heard the PC version doesn't include all the stuff that the DS version has. Like, all the extra stuff. Oh, different inputs? That's easier. It's just kind of funny that, despite the multiple releases of Chrono Trigger, there's still not a definitive version of Chrono Trigger. And that's the same for a lot of games. Waiting for the full... Do you think that might happen? Not remastered. No. Like, let's not forget, fans were trying to do that, but then Square's like, nah, we can't let you do that. I don't think it's 100% impossible. I just don't think it's likely. Right. Like, it'd be one thing if they were actually gonna do something. Like, they say, okay, guys, you can't do this because we're gonna do something. But no, it's not even that. Like, it wasn't even, like, the Metroid 2 situation. Because at least Nintendo... Oh, yeah, take a time. Yeah, because at least Nintendo... was like, yeah, we can't let you guys do this because we're actually making a remake ourselves. And even then, they let the game run for a few days. I was just saying, at least with Nintendo, when it came to Metroid 2, at least when they stopped the fan game, they're like, they only did it because they had their own game, their own remake. And even then, Nintendo was like, they even let the game run for a few days before they took it down. So that way people could at least get the game, the remake, or the fan project. But no, Square didn't even do that. Square's a very frustrating company. I love Square, and at the same time, I'm frustrated with them. Oh yeah, for sure. Something like the Metroid 2 remake, yeah, that's never leaving the internet. Especially such a good remake as it is, fan project as it is. Most of the time, yeah. For sure. Dang it, Cecil. Yeah, that's honestly, that's the only downside that I feel like to this version of Final Fantasy IV. But it is an easy fix, admittedly. Because somebody actually made a mod where you can install the Mystic Quest font, and oh my god, it looks so beautiful with this game. Yeah, you refuse to use... Listen. I have no excuse. You jerk! How dare you! Nah, that's funny. I go back and forth with it. Like, it's not even a mod. All you're doing is just switching fonts. Which, that wouldn't really break my rule. Because whenever I play these games or stream them, I like to... be as accurate as possible. Oh yeah, take your time. Oh my god, that was a lot of damage. You know what? I have played most of the game with this font. Let me download it, dang it. People have over-downloaded the font. That's amazing. Just when I send them one visits, that's how they get you. I was actually looking up a download link for the Mystic Quest font. I think I played it enough times at this point that I'm going to go into the final dungeon with the Mystic Quest font. Only problem is, so many people has downloaded it that it's, that it's over capacity, like, there's just been too many downloads for it. That's pretty funny. Next time I do stream it, I am gonna give. That is a very good message, yeah. Yeah, honestly, Square had no excuse on that front. More so, if you actually look at the Mist font in this game, it's actually pixelated. It actually looks good. So there is pixelated font in the game. Or at least in the Mist font. Yeah, I'm gonna see if I can... Yeah, I'm definitely gonna get this downloaded. I just gotta find a way to get to it. Thank you. I am back. Yeah, I'm just having a hard time finding a proper download link for it right this moment, but next time I stream Final Fantasy IV, I'm definitely gonna get the Mystic Quest font. That's gonna be next stream. I was dedicating this one to trying to get the monster drops. Which is, they increased the rate for it, but it's still pretty hard to get. Ah, same guy. Tomato, tomato. That's not what I wanted. No, it wasn't. Oh, wow, back to back. Okay. That's funny. That hasn't happened in a little bit. Wanna be famous? Nah, I'm allergic to being famous. I'll break out in hives. Joke's on you, I'm already am. Hey, there you go. I'm already famous. My mommy said so. And she's never wrong. Who makes those particular ones? I'm not too sure. I know the other ones that's been harassing people lately. Those were created by two people, and it seems like Twitch has been working on those. I would hope not. I would hope people wouldn't fall for it. Like, I can see maybe, like, a younger kid falling for it, but from what I understand, they're not supposed to be streaming on Twitch unless they're 13 or older. Without parental supervision. But then again, I don't know. Twitch might change its rules. She's, like, shaking her head. It's like, where's my life gone to? But to be fair, it could be Minecraft. To this day, I've still not played Fortnite. And honestly, I don't really have a motivation to play Fortnite. Minecraft is fine, but kids these days don't play any other stuff. You're not wrong. Alright, thanks for coming out. Best of luck with the rest of your work shift. Take easy, be careful, all that good stuff. Peace and love. Thank you. Ooh, Radio Learn Meteor. Nice. Very nice. So Radio can actually catch Meteor without dying like Tella. Alrighty. It's just not that. Oh, that's depressing that you can't download this right now. I gotta find a spawn. No, not the sound font. I already have the sound font for Mystic Quest. Look okay. Somebody did a Earthbound font. for the games. I'm grinding decent EXP here too, so that's pretty good. Oh, what am I doing? I can just rest on the thing. Fragment. That's why you don't go to random websites you're not familiar with. Bizarre clicking noises like that. I'm actually finding mods of, like, graphical mods for, Final Fantasy IV. It's pretty funny. Honestly, kind of surprising how hard I'm having a hard time finding this fun. I don't want the Final Fantasy VI on. Thank you. Here we go. Okay, I found it. I found one. Alright, we're good. We are in there. Might actually pause the stream here, or not pause the stream, but pause the game here in just a moment. See if I can get these mods working. Yeah, let me do this real quick. Let me switch it over to the loading screen. Make sure I got this correctly. All right, let's see if this works. That looks pretty good. I gotta get used to it after seeing the other font for so long, though, but it looks pretty good. like it. It's very Super Nintendo. I like it. Oh, the numbers are a little off, though. On the MP side. Well, it's not too bad. But I definitely, for sure, when I get the rest of the Pixel remasters at, later down the road, I'm definitely going to be using this font, for sure. Unless they update it at any point. Or, you know, the Final Fantasy 7 font happens, you know. Just throwing that out there. I got about another 20 minutes or so. But yeah, next session I am going to go ahead and tackle the last dungeon for the most part. Up till the Flame Princess at least. Or I might try to do up till the very final boss. Try to grind some sirens too. But that won't be till Saturday. Is everybody 70 yet? No. Radia and Edge are actually like 4 levels behind. That's pretty crazy. Yeah, got all chests. I was doing that one-handed. I had my drink in the other hand. A lot of ambush. I might go change scenarios and go grind on goblins. Yeah, let's do that. Go mix it up for the last 20 minutes. There's any guides on Steam right now for like tips and tricks. According to Steam, I've been playing this for 20 hours. Yeah, that might seem about right. Hey, goblins. Cool. There is a goblin in the last dungeon that we can grind on for the drop as well. I think these are so weak, though, these encounters, I think it's just... Alright, just to go through them quickly. Even if it's not goblins. It's just been good luck, though. That's a good one. The more goblins, the higher the chance. No luck. Ocean. have to worry about changing rows because they just have so little HP. Are you kidding me? I can get that. I can get another one of those, but I can't get anything else. That's funny. Here we go, okay. I found a guy here. Especially since I've been able to discover drop mechanic works in the Final Manners for Pixel Remaster. Any enemy in the formation has a 5% chance to drop an item. Okay. Every enemy in the formation can drop an item if you're lucky enough. Even another enemy of the same type has already dropped an item. Yes, we have seen where we had two item drops from the one enemy encounter. If an item, this is the thing, if an item is dropped, there's a 2% chance for it to be an ultra rare drop. So it looks like it was increased to 2%. Okay. Yeah, it's a little too late for me to grind off the sirens. Class. Nice. I'm reading some notes here too. I know I'm approaching 3 hours in, but I'm probably going to go ahead and just extend it for another 20 minutes or so. That'll be 2 p.m. my time, and that'll be all right with me. Eye drops. But I can't go any longer than 2 p.m. unfortunately. As much as I would love to keep grinding all day, I actually really enjoy grinding in these games. Like any kind of RPGs, I just love it. And I'm not being exaggerated. Like I actually really enjoy it. It's like therapeutic in a way. Like I definitely like seeing numbers go big. If that makes any sense. I think that's why I really like NIS games. Can we get back? Hold on, I'm thinking. I'm looking up something here. Wait, the tunnelers can drop it? Can they really? 12.5%. I mean, that'd be a longer process, maybe. Can I? No, I can't get back to the underground one. I'm kind of locked out of Tower of Babel. Not what we wanted. Green dragons have a pretty high chance of dropping it. Okay. And they are a good place to grind, too. Let's do that. Green jackets are just a little bit tricky to encounter where I'm at. I flow by it, buy it. Go ahead, rest up. Checking something here. we gotta let this thing hatch. And hopefully it's a dragon. Hey, there's a dragon. Cool. But they have a 37.5% chance of dropping a siren. But we have to have that 5% chance of dropping an item at all first, is the thing. Okay, these have a chance of dropping at the tarantula. I mean, so many ways I can deal about this. Okay, let me think about this. Goblins ain't an issue. I run into them in so many random encounters with them. That's fine. The Mind Flayer is just one that I need, but apparently I can just do it right at the entrance and be alright. And the grenades, I can just... Well, I mean, the grenades, there's no real way you can do with the sirens. And I already got the bird. So, okay, yeah. It's just a matter of time, really. But like I said, next session, I will, I'm gonna do the last dungeon. So I got about 10 more minutes. Come on, give me a goblin drop. Not another bird. I should have stole more sirens or grinded them. That was on me, though. I don't want that.
I still got the shuffle, the Cecil shuffle.
Sound. Those are pretty good. I always like the how funny it is that the enemy that can cause, like, you know, for example, blindness. We'll drop eye drops. It's just kind of funny. Well, I mean, I did get a monster drop this session. It's just not one that I needed. Thank you.
not even a potion.
He's like, oh, fine, you want a potion? Here's a potion.
You jerk. I had a 5% chance to get that potion. SKPM. Let me do one more encounter, then I'm gonna call it a session. Unfortunately, we didn't get any monster drops, but we did get a few more treasure chests, which that's pretty cool. And we did get a sword for Kane, so there's that. Well, we did get a monster drop, but not the one we needed. I still can't get over that. But yeah, that's gonna be it. Tomorrow, I will be doing this guy RPG, which the Asagi banner will be out. So I'm gonna be doing a lot of pulls on that. And, you know, some Friday Night Funkin' stuff, if anything pops up for that. But yeah, this is gonna be it. When I stream this Saturday, I will, do the final dungeon. And, go from there, try to grind on the, Flame Princess. Which I have a feeling that won't be as terrible as the monster drops. Because whenever I did do playthroughs of Final Fantasy IV, I've always gotten the Flame Princess stuff, but never the monster encounters. So, the Flame Princess should be a little bit easier. I'm not going to be grinding for all five characters, though. I'm just going to be doing for the one character. But yeah, so that will be it. And then... So, possibly there will be just two more streams of Final Fantasy IV. Saturday and Sunday night. No. Yes. It's going to be late Sunday night because it'll be laundry day for me. And I visit the folks every time I go do the laundry. Okay. But yeah, that's going to be it. I want to thank everybody who came out. Check out the stream, even just for a little bit. Thank you to anybody on YouTube who catches the replay later on. And yeah. Take care, everybody. Brush your teeth. And, yeah, have a lovely day.